We all know there is a huge buzz about meditation, and while so many people swear by it, there are plenty of people who really think that kar kya rahe hain, baithe to rahe hain, they're just whiling away their time. Hansaji, you have to shed some light. A lot of people have a lot of misconceptions. What is meditation and why is it so important?
Yeah, I liked your this point that people are just wasting time, na, just sitting and doing nothing. But actually, this is what people have to learn, to sit quietly also. In yoga, they say that meditation is the thing which would remove all the obstacles, all the weaknesses, all the problems, pains and suffering from your system. Mm. So it's like a medicine, it's like a treatment, it is something which really would train your mind. But do you know what type of a mind we have? Human mind is mentioned as monkey mind, continuously thinking from one thought to another thought, and that also is not normal. The not normal monkey, intoxicated monkey, and above all, intoxicated monkey which is stung with Scorpio. How is that monkey would be restless? That would be human mind. So such a mind is worthless, useless. Mind has to be focused. If mind is focused, then mind can learn something out of it, can pick up right knowledge out of it, otherwise not. Mm. So human mind needs training. That's what yogis talk about. Mm. And what is the training? One, of course, that whatever work you are doing, do it with mind. With mind. You are brushing, see that mind is present there. You are eating, see that mind is present there. Don't allow mind to run here and there, but keep your mind with you. Because we are
being in the present rather than shifting thoughts.
Exactly. We are body and mind together. Don't become disintegrated personality. Become integrated. And so this is the beginning of meditation. Mm-hmm. That you are becoming aware about your mind.
All the things that you said is beautiful and they are the effects. Mm-hmm. But what is meditation really?
Well, it is a technique. Mm-hmm. Yoga has lots of techniques to offer. And these are the techniques. Meditation has lots of varieties of meditative techniques. And with this technique, you try and train your mind to become more focused. Concentration is the beginning of meditation. Concentration and then prolonged concentration is meditation. It is very simple. Mm-hmm. So it is a concentration. So learn to concentrate on everything in life. But when I ask you a question about anything, do we do this or we not do this? What would you say? That my heart wants me to do this, but my head wants me to do this. So we are always in confused state to do or not to do. I feel like doing this, but my head says no. Now this head and heart, which is both are very active in our personality when it comes to thinking, meditation unites them. So this confusion is gone. Faith and devotion. These are two words used. You must have faith in meditation. And faith has to be generated. So when you have faith in meditation, then you understand what your heart is saying, what your head is saying, and then you unite, and that is a perfect technique of meditation.
How is this faith really generated for complete non-believers, Hansaji? With practice?
Faith doesn't mean believing in God. Faith means believing in your action, what you are doing. Mm-hmm. Now in meditation, person has to have faith. And in meditation, person has to follow these techniques which are mentioned. Mm. Now there are various yoga techniques which are there, which we can discuss. I can say, talk about it. But today, let us understand that meditation really helps you to relax. Mm-hmm. Now we are all working under tension. So if we could sit quietly and focus our mind on something, we are meditating. We are not thinking about varieties of things, but thinking about one thing. That's meditation. So trying to see that you are either just listening to sound and not thinking about anything. That's meditation. Or you are just smelling a good fragrance. And you are getting tuned with that fragrance. You love it and so you are there. You are not thinking about anything. You are doing meditation. Mm-hmm. Or You are just feeling the touch of air on your body and sitting quietly. That's meditation. Or you are just watching your breath, how it is coming and going. You are not thinking about it, nor interfering with it.
You're not engaged with it.
Yes, not engaged with it, because breath continuously changes with the state of mind. Its speed and everything. Watch your breath. That's meditation. So trying to see things without bringing thoughts. Trying to hear varieties of things without bringing your own thoughts. This we have to learn in
just
life.
Just as is.
As it is. Be objective in listening. Passive listener. Passive observer. Such traits we have to bring in our personality. And you will notice that then world becomes very beautiful. Because all unnecessary thoughts are gone. That's why meditation should be part of your day-to-day routines. Sometimes I find people are too painful. They are under stress. They are under worry, heavy worry. And they don't know what to do now. Suddenly a loss in business. Suddenly something happened. Now instead of thinking what will happen to me and what will I do and all that, just sit quietly and sit in meditation. It really works, and then you sleep out also. And in the morning when you get up, you get a very correct idea that this is what now you are supposed to do. Who is going to give you direction? Your inner self. Once you do meditation, you go deeper to your inner self, your consciousness, and then you get an answer. So big problems are solved when you sit and meditate.
Thank you, Hansaji. The most beautiful aspect of meditation is to really get connected within, like she said. And that I found the most precious virtue of meditation. I hope all of us do connect within and stay completely beautiful. Thank you.